Good morning, children. So this is the second module of reported speech. So as you know, there are various types of sentences in English. So in this module we are going to do that only, and with each sentences we have different rules apart from the basic rules. I hope that you have already written all the rules in your classwork. So first is the assertive sentences. Assertive sentences means simple sentences or affirmative sentences. Okay. So the rule is, said to changes into told. You have to remove the inverted commas, and here we use that conjunction. Fine, children. According to expression, said to can be changed into replied, informed, added, remarked, pleaded, reminded, complained, etc. So it's not compulsory that every time said to changes into told, but yes, sometimes according to the expression, you can change said to into replied, informed, remarked, pleaded, or any other such word. Fine. So here we have an example. The servant said to his master, I have done my best and can do no more for you. Okay, so here I have changed said to into told, but yes, you can change said to into informed also. The servant informed his master, or the servant told his master. So I have removed comma and double inverted commas, and I have used that conjunction. So in a set of sentences, you have to use that conjunction. Fine. That he had done, I have done, will change into he had done. Have done is a present perfect, it will change to past perfect, had done. His best and can changes into could, do no more good for him. Fine. So apart from the assertive sentences, you have to keep in mind the basic rules also. In the last video, I have told you that can changes into could. Fine. So combining both the things, the basic rules as well as this rule, you can change the sentences. Next is interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences means sentences which have the question mark, or questioning sentences are called interrogative sentences. So here, reporting verb said to changes into asked. Fine. Said to changes into asked. See, children, interrogative sentences can start in two ways. First, it can start with auxiliary verb. Auxiliary verb means helping verb. Is, am, are, was, were, do, does, did, has, have, and all models. Models means can, could, may, might, shall, should. So it can start with auxiliary verb or with WH family. So WH family means where, what, how, who, whose, when, which. So you have to keep in mind that if it starts with auxiliary verb or helping verb, you are going to use if or whether. Fine. In assertive sentence, you have to use that conjunction. In interrogative sentence, if it starts with auxiliary verb, you have to use if or whether. Only one you have to use. Fine. And if it starts with WH family, no conjunction is used. Here, you can see the example. She said to her servant, is tea ready for me? Question mark is there at the end. And the interrogative sentence is started with is, that is auxiliary verb. So said to changes into asked. She asked her servant if tea was ready for her. Okay, so here the subject will come first and then helping verb, and we have removed the double inverted commas also. Second example I have taken of WH. He said to his mother, why have you not washed my school dress? He asked his mother why. See, I have not used here any conjunction, no conjunction will be used here. He asked his mother why she had not washed his school dress. Fine. So, see children, why she had not. If you write why had she not, it's wrong. So, you have to keep in mind that in interrogative sentences, in interrogative sentences, subject will come first. So, she will come first and then helping verb. I think both types of sentences are clear to you. Now the next is imperative sentences. Fine. Imperative sentences means sentences of command, request or advice. So here set two changes into order, requested, advised, warned. That will be according to your expression. And here we are going to use to as conjunction. Fine. So here we have an example. The general said to the soldiers, march forward and attack the foe. Here the spelling is wrong. F-O-E should be there. Sorry. The general commanded the soldier to march. Okay. So here what is there? I have removed the inverted comma, and in imperative sentence you are going to use to conjunction. To march forward and attack the foe. F-O-E. Next is, she said to me, do not pluck the flowers. She forbade me to pluck the flowers. So if you use this forbid word, you are not going to use do not. Or if you want, it can be changed in other way also. She asked me not to pluck the flowers. Do not can change into not to also. She asked me not to pluck the flowers. Now we have the sentences when you have let in the sentence, how we are going to change it. Set changes into proposed or suggested to. So whenever you have the sentences with let at that time, said will change into proposed to or suggested to. Fine. And let will change into we should or they should. Sometimes we use to let also. So let's see the example. She said to me, let us go to Oaklaw for a picnic. She proposed to me. So said to is changed into proposed to. Okay. Here I have used that conjunction as same way as we have used in assertive sentences, that we should go to Okla for a picnic. And sometimes we don't use here let. Okay, so Rani said to the teacher, let me go home early. Rani requested the teacher to let her go home early. Fine, children. So sometimes we use to also, thus the remaining sentence will remain the same. So children, all the rules, you are going to copy all these rules in your classwork. Fine. You have to copy, apart from the basic rules, you are going to copy all the rules. Whatever rules I have just written here, I have given you in the slide, you are going to write in your classwork. Fine. And please learn all the rules by heart. In this module, we have discussed three types of sentences, that is assertive, interrogative and imperative sentences. Once again, I will just revise those. It's very simple. In assertive sentence, you will use that conjunction. Said to, changes into told or sometimes replied, informed, added also. Interrogative sentence starts with in two ways, auxiliary verb or WH. If it starts with WH, no conjunction is used. And if it starts with auxiliary verb, if or whether is used. In the same way, imperative sentences. Said to changes into order, requested, advised or warned. Okay, and here we use to conjunction. If it is with let, if you have the sentences with let, at that time, said changes into proposed to or suggested to, and let changes into we should or they should, and sometimes to let also. That depends upon your sentence. I think these rules are very much clear to you. And if you have any doubts, we will clear in our live class. Okay, children, thank you.